Quiero estar dormido que despierto de tanto que me duele que no esté.
Mariachi music slices through the silence. The melody is meant to soothe the family's sorrow. The cruelness of COVID-19 on display. This is a funeral in a parking lot.
My mother was a very strong woman, and she fought to the very last breath.
Juliana Jimenez Sesma says these are the last words they exchanged.
I told her, Mom, do not be afraid, for the Lord is with us. I love you, and may God bless you. Keep strong for me, Mom. And all she answered me was, yes, mija. Yes, mija, with that voice, with fear.
Sesma lived with and cared for her mom, who had a lung condition. Her stepdad had asthma and diabetes. Her brother lives right next door with his young family.
How many people ended up getting it? Did everyone get it?
All of us.
Her stepfather and then mother ended up here, Martin Luther King Jr. Community Hospital. They fought to live, just like those filling all the ICU beds now. But they died within 11 days of each other. Dr. Jason Prosso treated both Sesma's parents.
I just wanted to know that we here tried our hardest, and we're really sorry that things went the way that they did.
The terrible scenario is not unusual, as COVID ensnares those who live in multi-generational families and are part of the essential workforce.
We have had the misfortune of seeing this disease run through families and all too frequently take multiple members of a single family.
The state-of-the-art hospital is an oasis of care in the healthcare desert of South Los Angeles. It is no wonder the heavily Black and Latino neighborhood is suffering disproportionately. The inequities in healthcare invites death.
His blood sugar dropped below 40.
Diabetes is 3 times more prevalent here than in the rest of California. Diabetes mortality is 72% higher. The life expectancy is 10 years shorter here than in the rest of the state. And all of that is related to this being an under-resourced and underserved community.
That was before coronavirus arrived.
We're running like well over 100% capacity.
The 131-bed facility is suddenly treating more than 200 patients. 60% of them are COVID patients. They've made space everywhere. Tents outside, inside hallways, the prayer room, a former gift shop. The battle to save a life, physically and mentally exhausting. But on this day, a surprise reminder of why they fight.
Okay. Hello, gang. I'm here. Hi. There she goes. There she goes.
You got dance moves. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
74-year-old Elaine Stevens returns to thank her doctor and nurses. She spent more than 40 days in this ICU before walking out alive.
I made it. A lot of days I didn't want to make it, but I did it.
As she celebrated a second chance at life, the ceremony for death was still playing out in a parking lot for the Sesma family.
Don't let this be you. If you truly love your loved ones, don't let this be you. Continue to, take all the cautious, take extra precautions. Exaggerate if you have to.
You know, this is the 10th hospital that I have been. I'm sorry. This is the 10th. I apologize. I'm going to try to get through this. This is the 10th hospital that I have been in. And to see the way that these families have to live after this and the heartache that goes so far and so wide. It's really hard to take. I'm sorry, Allison.
Hey, Sarah, no apology. No apology needed. We've been watching your reporting on the ground throughout this horrific year. And we have all been struck by the grief, the collective grief that all of us are in. And to see these families who are soldiering through it, who are persevering, and who are having to have these funerals in parking lots, like the ones that you showed us, it is just a collective trauma that all of us are living through. And Sarah, we all appreciate the heart that you bring to this every single day, as well as your excellent reporting.
thanks. It's just not okay. It's not okay what we're doing to each other. These families should not be going through this. No family should be going through this. So please listen to what this family is saying. Don't let this be you. Do whatever you can to keep this from killing your family members and your neighbors and your friends and your teachers and doctors and firefighters. All of these people are here to help you, but you have to do your part.